Is learning web development a good idea in 2025? One word answer, yes, video ends. But the point of making this video is to show you what you are missing in web development learning in the AI age. See, the point is, I believe anyone can build a simple website these days. Like, I asked my niece, who is in class 9, to build a simple website showing your name, your photo, and some information about you. Prior to this, she had zero knowledge of any of these things. She typed a simple prompt into ChatGPT asking how to create an HTML file and run it. She followed the steps, and within 10 minutes, she showed me a simple portfolio website. And this fascinated her so much that she started to search simple questions related to the project, like what is div, classes, styles, headers, body, title, and so on. And I'm damn sure if I guide her a little bit, she will make a simple React website too. Whatever my niece did was a part of web development, and 5 years ago, these things would take developers a week to grasp, but now times have changed. I won't say that the traditional method of learning web development is outdated, but if you choose this path, it will take you a lot of time and it might lead you to FOMO, which means fear of missing out. Because you know, everything in the AI age is growing exponentially. So you might now ask me, what would you do if you were in my shoes? Okay, let me tell you. I was reading a blog by Sam Altman, and he wrote that they are working on a new technology which everyone is unaware of and which no one fully understands. So sometime in terms of growth, they take 2 steps forward and then 1 step back to rectify mistakes. And sometime they take 1 step forward and 2 step backward to rectify mistakes. Well, if the frontiers of AI are using this method for exponential growth, then you can apply this too. So if I had zero knowledge, I would start of course with HTML and CSS. I would give myself 3 projects here. The first one will be a basic to clear my fundamentals. The second project will be mid-level, and the third one will be advanced. But here, I will make sure that I go through only HTML and CSS, no JavaScript, no jQuery, nothing else. This phase shouldn't take more than 2 weeks, and with focus, you might finish in just 1.5. But from day 1, I will use AI tools like ChatGPT, Claude, and Grok. These AI tools are free and good. In this phase, my step backward is learning things I don't understand. For example, in my first project, there would be many things I don't understand. In the middle of the project, I will ask the AI to explain those things. Like, what is a header, why it is used, what if we don't use the body tag, why the body tag is necessary. Remember, you can ask even the stupid question, no one is judging you. It's your way of learning. And remember, if you don't understand, ask the AI to explain things in very simple language. If I still don't understand, I will ask again. By your second project, you will start seeing progress. And by the third, you will feel unstoppable. In the third project, try to write some code on your own. This will free your hands and boost your confidence. You will make a ton of mistakes here, but remember, AI is your genie here. So within no time, you will figure it out. And within 2 weeks, you will have built 3 different projects, and trust me, you will be good. And now you might ask, I don't know what projects to build. Well, let me finish the learning journey of web development. Then I will name 3 unique projects and give you a secret tip. Now, the second step of learning web development is getting used to JavaScript. See, JavaScript is a god-tier language, which means if you start getting into it, your brain might feel pass out. But yeah, it's the only way here. Again, a maximum of 2 weeks. Get used to the fundamentals like syntax, structure, control flow, functions, objects and prototypes, DOM manipulations, array and error handling. And why these are necessary? Because in the third step, when you start building React projects, there will be JavaScript. Or you can also use TypeScript, but let's keep it to JavaScript. There, JavaScript will be used, and I don't want you to feel like you don't know what's going on. At least all those functions and structures you have seen before will be familiar. So again, in the third step, you have to build a lot of projects. Here you can choose Next.js too, but you have to be brave enough to make a quick jump from React. I can't say the Next.js is an advanced version of React, but it's a framework built on top of React, so the switch should be easy. Remember, in the third step, you have to build, let's say, 20 to 30 projects. From beginner to expert. The first 5 projects will be easy, the next 5 mid-level, the next 10 advanced, and the last 10 expert. Again, our way of learning would be the same. Anything you don't understand, just copy and paste it into any AI tool and ask a ton of questions related to it. Any mistake you make, just ask the AI about it. But in each step, after you get familiar with the basics and logic buildings, try to write some code on your own. This will boost your confidence and in the learning phase, push you forward. Now, a few of you might wonder, if AI is writing code so well, then why are we writing the code when it will slowly replace us anyway? Yes, AI will replace developers, but only the mediocre ones who don't upgrade themselves. Tell me one thing, has web development technology stopped upgrading? The answer is no, because no technology is perfect, and it's evolving. Remember, It's not just about writing some piece of code, it's about solving a specific problem. And once you figure out how to solve a problem, AI will help you write the code. Now earlier, I mentioned that I would tell you about 3 HTML and CSS projects to start with. And here they are. Start with a portfolio card of yourself, then for the mid-level, go for the weather dashboard. And for the advanced level, craft a map of a small area like a campus or neighborhood, where hovering over or focusing on different areas reveal information. But remember one thing, from day one of your learning, try to document each and everything. Like what you learned today, talk about your mistakes, talk about the project, and you can do all this on Twitter or X, whatever you prefer to call it. If you do this, it might help you in landing a job, and if not, for sure you will be accepted into the web development community. Also, if you want me to tell you about the 30 projects you should build using React and Next.js, let me know in the comments. This video is already too long, I guess. I will make a separate video for that. And for now, it's action time. So set your timeline and let's rock and roll. Bye.